Hello, child of God. By now you have watched the first two 15-minute videos concerning deliverance from obesity. This is part three, and your deliverance will be very, very, very soon now. Listen to what the Lord Jesus Christ himself said concerning this issue of authority to cast out demons.
And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding in this rejoice not, that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven.
I agree with what Jesus said, and I want to tell you a scriptural fact. When the Lord Jesus Christ delegated his name to the church on earth, with it, he delegated his authority over Satan, among many other things. When you or I speak to these demons in Satan's earthly kingdom, we are speaking as if we are the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Satan and his kingdom know it. The Holy Spirit knows it. You and I know it. But do we really operate in that truth to the point of effectively manifesting the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ in power? My mother had a bank account, and because of her age and health, I was given power of attorney to write checks and manage her estate. I was only limited to the amount of cash in her bank account and the fair market value of her estate. I legally wrote checks and paid doctors. The bank honored my mother's checks because I had authority to sign her name. I used her bank card and typed in the PIN. The purchases were approved, and it was all legally done. It was not complicated. She paid her bills, and I was her ambassador. The laws of the kingdom of God are much like that. I'm an ambassador of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit is the banker with the power to accomplish whatever is commanded by Jesus. When the Holy Spirit gets a legally authorized demand for payment, he pays the bill. The signature on the check is the Lord Jesus Christ. The only limits on what checks we can write are the limits of our own faith and our own love. You can have unlimited faith in the love of God. Jesus went to the cross to save us before we ever knew we needed a Savior because of God's love for us, like John 3:16 says. Our faith should be fully invested in the love of Almighty God toward us. God wants us to be delivered from all the power of the enemy. We have authority to cast out demons, and we have faith in the love and the will of God. So why is it that we struggle so hard at times against the works of Satan's kingdom? It is written that my people die from a lack of knowledge. Sometimes we complicate simple deliverance with so many issues of do this and don't do that. When I say, child of God, by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive your sin, spiritually speaking, it is the Lord Jesus Christ forgiving your sin. When I say, by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command all of the spirits of the kingdom of Satan to leave this child of God, spiritually speaking, it is the Lord Jesus Christ speaking to the kingdom of Satan and commanding them to leave. So my faith is not really in my faith. My faith is in the divine character and power of the Lord Jesus Christ. The bank of the Holy Spirit is open, so let us begin with a short prayer and acknowledge Jesus as our benefactor. Father God, that's right, just address the Father and pray after me. Father God, we thank you for giving your Holy Son, Jesus, on the cross to save us. We thank you for his blood that has cleansed us and his name that has delivered us. Now we ask that you add your faith and love to our words and exalt the name of Jesus above every name that is named, here, now, on earth, and also in heaven. Give us the mind of Christ to think the thoughts of Christ and to speak the words of Christ, and the gift of peace of the Lord Jesus Christ that exceeds all understanding. We ask that you glorify Jesus and deliver your children that are agreeing with me in this prayer. I ask this by the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I now forgive every sin and now command the peace gift of the Lord Jesus Christ upon this child of God listening to this video. Now, child of God, I'm going to command the demon spirits troubling you to leave and not return, as if I am the Lord Jesus Christ, and they will be forced to leave by the Holy Spirit. I'm posting these words that I command so that you can also command in agreement. Child of God, this is your part in these deliverance commands. First, you should agree with the commands and acknowledge your agreement as I post the acknowledgement. Even if it seems silly to you, sometimes Almighty God uses the foolish things to confound the wise. And as I speak these commands, you should also speak by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. And when we have finished, have faith that God does not lie. What we do now is manifested by the Holy Spirit. So pay attention and work with me as your teammate as we begin this deliverance manifestation. Speak out the words that I've written. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I make these commands to every demon associated with and influencing in any way this blood-washed child of the Most High God listening to this video. I command you, demons, to totally and permanently release this listener now. I also command you to totally and permanently release each other and come out of this child of God now. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command you demons to recognize that the blood of Jesus was paid to purchase this listener from Satan's kingdom. And the Lord Jesus Christ totally revoked and dismissed all of your claims to this child of God listening to this video. I command you to recognize your total defeat now. Almighty God can see you tormented in the lake of fire. The Lord Jesus Christ commands each of you to come out and permanently leave this person now that is listening to this video. I now speak to the child of God listening to this video. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command and proclaim healing manifested in your mind, your will, and your emotions so that you can obtain the mind of Christ and think the thoughts of Christ and speak the words of Christ. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command this listener's entire body to continuously resist disease, illness, and death 7 times more efficiently, all according to the design of Almighty God. By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I release and set free the child of God listening to this video from the entire condition of obesity and all of its causes, including demonic causes, emotional causes, spiritual, mental, and physical causes. Whom the Lord Jesus Christ has set free is free indeed. You are hereby set free from all the power and all the strength of obesity and all the power and strength of the causes of obesity. It has been done. Amen. Well, child of God, we should continue to give Almighty God the glory for this gift of deliverance and healing and worship Him in spirit and in truth. Your part now should also be continuing to seek to have the mind of Christ and continue in your war against obesity. Make the changes. God is on your side.
Be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resist, steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion for ever and ever. Amen.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Child of God, we can only see into the spiritual kingdom when we are guided by the Holy Spirit. We continue each day to fight the powers of darkness. But demons are not totally responsible for our obesity. While demons open the door to obesity by attempting to destroy our minds and our bodies, we all make some very bad food choices. We can stop the demons from influencing our minds, but it is our own responsibility to change our minds and to make better food and exercise choices. Hebrews 9:14 tells us that our consciousness is cleansed from dead works by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. When I became a born-again Christian, I was still thinking in that foul language as sailors speak so fluently. And when you think in profanities for so many years, profanities roll off your tongue as a normal language you speak. When I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit and learned more about the blood of Jesus and the authority of the name of Jesus, the battle continued on in my head. I was not mature enough then to know whether the words were coming from demons influencing me or just my normal kind of stinking thinking. I became aware that when a garbage thought popped into my head from any source at all, I needed to fight it. In comes the filth, and out of my mouth goes, "I rebuke you, Satan, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, get away from me." Sometimes I said, "I rebuke that thought in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, get away from me." Resist Satan in your thoughts, and when you can, say it out loud. Make the decision to think or say words like this: "By the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I rebuke you, Satan, get away from me." Even when your stinking thinking is not from the voice of demons, our mind was a storehouse of the memories of Satan's influence. I wanted the mind of Christ, to think the thoughts of Christ, and speak the words of Christ with power and authority. This does not come overnight, but I was amazed at how fast rebuking works when Satan attempts to distract or discourage prayer and Bible study. Resist Satan, and he will flee from you. This is another tool we can use to fight obesity. Rat poison is 99% good wheat that tastes very good to the rat. However, the 1% anticoagulant is what causes the internal bleeding and kills the rat. We are much smarter than the rats, but we still eat food that tastes good, and the poison in the food is killing us too. As I continue to speak for the next 2 minutes or so, practice the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ each time you think about something you should not eat. Say it out loud: "I rebuke that thought in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ." Child of God, before we proceed to part four, I would like to introduce to you a very controversial tool in weight loss for Christians. Most of our lives, we have been bombarded with food commercials. The strategy of these advertisers is to produce a picture of happiness in your mind when you eat whatever food that they are promoting. And just who doesn't know the Folgers coffee song about the best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup? It is a catchy song that we hear often. For a few seconds, it promotes the image of happiness in our thoughts. The Folgers commercial may only run 30 seconds or so at a time, but you may hear it 20 or more times a week. That becomes roughly 10 minutes a week of the commercial form of hypnotic suggestion. Advertisers are very successful because they use scientifically correct methods of influencing the thoughts of the public. The commercials exist because they work on humans. If the commercials were not proven to work cost-effectively, they just would not exist. We are now bombarded with hypnotic suggestions to eat processed foods from our early childhood until the day we die. We have developed and groomed a taste and cravings for horrible foods that are killing us. And just what are your favorite foods? We are certainly not robots, and we're not zombies, but the mental programming of the masses is evident in our decisions to buy Slim Jims, Twinkies, fast foods, and especially many other foods loaded with corn syrup, sugars, fats, hydrogenated oils, salts, GMOs, and many other harmful chemicals I can't even pronounce. Hypnotic suggestion works, and I think it would be foolish for us not to confront these commercial forms of hypnotic suggestion since we have been bombarded with food commercials for our entire lives. I made a 15-minute video tool designed to help us overcome some of our mental programming. We will not fall into a trance or act foolishly or anything like that. This tool is designed to be a form of hypnotic suggestion we can call self-hypnosis that may just help you on your path to overcome obesity. On this video, I am confessing God's word in truth. I would suggest that you make the video a favorite and play it a couple of times a day, perhaps once in the morning and once in the evening before you fall asleep. Since it is so controversial, I'm including a short sample, and after the sample, you'll see a link to the video. You will also see a link to part four, Deliverance from Demons Influencing Obesity. Because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive my body for getting fat. Because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive my body for resisting me losing weight. Because of the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive every lie of, I cannot lose weight.